How many people do you think will turn up?
Well, we'll probably have about 200 today.
Oh, there'll be a queue, won't there? There'll be a queue, all right.
Liz Truss has insisted there'll be no public spending.
You've got no words for it, have you, really?
Why don't you take the cereal out of the packet?
We can't afford to give them a full box.
We can't give a full box.
We just don't have it. I mean, we just haven't got enough. They used to.
Yeah. We've not got much vegetables today. And that's a problem that we're concerned about, is the donations which are going down. Because people haven't got the money and because the supermarkets don't have any surplus that they used to.
Grim and awkward, really. But I don't really like filming people who have this level of need, you know. But there again, this is the reality of it. All those abstract words you hear, the cost of living and crises of one kind or another, well, that's what it looks like.
Can we talk to you for a minute?
What?
Life.
Life?
Yeah.
Life's what you make of it, innit?
Grimsby was right at the heart of that big political shift that began really with the Brexit referendum of 2016 and climaxed with the general election in 2019 when we were last here. And with everything completely up in the air, this seemed like a really good time to come back.
Go on, Ross. I'll do it if you do it.
Go on. That was life at the minute. Financially, more than anything else, I suppose.
Difficult.
Go on.
I've got two children that I've got to pay for childcare and feeding them.
What's difficult in particular?
Having to say no, isn't it?
Wow.
Yeah, that's the hardest thing for me, because I'm a big softie. But, you know, that's the hardest thing, is saying no to kids.
God, that's such a sort of everyday thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Days out with the kids. Doing nice things with the kids, we just can't afford to do it anymore. I don't know what's gone wrong. I try not to watch the news anymore because it makes me too nervous. And I think now I worry for my children more than I worry for myself. Because I've had the help of my mum and dad, and I'm scared that I won't be able to help my kids the same way.
What's happened down here?
We're making a film about Grimsby. How's your life at the minute?
Oh, it's okay, I've just closed my business down, so.
You've just closed your business though?
Yeah, I own the gym down there.
Go on.
Above there, we're just stripping it down now. The electricity and the power situation, we just couldn't survive anymore, so we've closed. It's just the way it is.
Are you walking down there now?
I am, yeah. I've lost a few friends to the COVID. That's been heartbreaking, but...
No sooner have we got through one thing than another one, do you know what I mean?
It's like something from an horror film, yeah.
I don't know why I'm laughing.
I know, but it is that bad that you can't do what else but laugh.
I suppose people had this idea that maybe we'd come out of the crash 15 years ago and, so, you know, things had changed and things would get better, and then maybe out of Brexit and then the pandemic, we emerged from that, build back better and all that. Do you remember that?
Yeah, it's the thing is, it's like everybody's waiting. I've stopped looking forward to things being over now. Just started to accept that we should just be happy and deal with the situation.
Is what's left of the gym. There's an envelope there that says final demand. Right, it's now 1 o'clock, which is when the Rock Foundation's food bank opens its doors.
It's not good, is it?
It's got a lot worse, and I think it is about to get a lot worse. Benefits not going up in line with inflation. I mean, I think that's going to hit me a lot harder.
Grimsby sort of Tory MP.
And I'm ashamed to say that because of Brexit last time, I voted for Tory. Only because I believe in democracy, and we voted to leave. So, I mean, nobody else is going to do that, you know. And I did vote for Boris last time. I'm ashamed to say, but definitely not next time.
You haven't got enough money to eat effectively at the minute.
No, because otherwise I won't be using the food bank.
Obviously, I'm a single parent. One of my conditions is a brain condition, so based on that, it affects my mobility, my nerves and everything like that. So you've got no choice but to survive on benefits.
Yeah.
A lot of people are quite embarrassed and feel ashamed and turn into food banks and that. It's not just me, and I know I'm not alone in on this.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's selfish for me to say it's just based on me when I know there's so many thousands of people in this country that are experiencing the same.
You came out of the army 13 years ago.
It's been hard to get back into civilian life again.
What's your financial situation at the minute?
I ain't got no money, mate. I ain't had no money for 2 months. Yeah. I've been in the dark, living with candles. Because I'm ex-army, I can survive. I was cooking dinner on the fire pit in the garden.
Where were you getting your food from?
The food bank, but they only do it once a day, so I just had to just starve a few days. Well, 2 days without food, and then one day on, I need to get a phone so they can contact me, but I can't get a phone because I sold it for food.
You haven't got a mobile either?
I had to sell it for food, or I'll be dead. I'm off to sell a coat for some food. Unless I've got everything I need in there. Not even joking.
I mean, for anybody, that's an impossible way to live, and it shouldn't happen.
Yeah,
but that's what I find particularly shocking, is that having been in the army, you shouldn't be having to live like this. You know what I mean? That's what I mean.
Well, it don't matter, does it?
It does
matter.
People
think I'm talking crap.
It's all gone very, very wrong, all this, isn't it? Somehow politics can sort of carry on using the sort of vapid language that it does and all that. You get a very strong sense here. Good people who deserve something better.
This country will be able to take back control of a massive industry once we get Brexit done in January. And there's a potential to do really well for UK fishing. Now, here in Grimsby, they land, they take in fish from Norway, from Iceland.
Can I ring you in about...
Why do you do it?
Freedom.
We've come to meet Darren Kenyon from Fastline Shellfish, one of Grimsby's few remaining fishermen. Well, so you've been talking to people like me for donkey's years.
Been doing it years now and now it happens.
Yeah. There you go.
Nothing seems to change.
What effect did Brexit have on your trade?
Well, Brexit, we all thought it was going to be good. You know, we all voted and, you know, we thought we was going to get our waters back and this, that and the other.
Well, we got led down the path again, didn't we? We did.
We was worse off when it came out. We got less fish. And then Boris come along and he gave us a little bit of hope. Oh, he was good at speaking. So it changed the vote overnight. We all voted for Boris. He come to Grimsby.
How do you feel about that now?
Well, I won't vote for anybody. Now then, Abdul, you're all right, mate. It's not the police. Your sizes, I just have got about 2 or 3 and that's it. No, you're not messing me about.
I'll take 4.
No, you're not.
20.
Go and have a look. There ain't any
I'll have
in
a
there.
Look.
Where do you deliver to?
Billingsgate.
Billingsgate. How's trade at the minute?
Tough.
Why is it tough?
Because we're not getting enough products. We're fighting everything. The price, the weather, everything. So that's what we're doing.
Brexit?
Absolutely.
Not helping.
Mate, Darren will tell you, we'll tell you. At the beginning, we were like, everybody's up for it. Nothing's happened.
Farage was going down the River Thames with his flotilla of fishing boats saying, I'm here to rescue the British fishing industry.
Listen, it's all bullshit. Yeah. Right, guys, take care.
Thank you.
So years ago, you'd have heard banging, clattering, men shouting, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Well, now it's just silent. Yeah.
This is it, what it's like after dinner. And it's horrible.
If you weren't here anymore, it's almost like Grimsby means less.
It's just a little tiny town now at the end of a motorway.
We try and take the long view, right? And really, you know, Liz Truss's meltdown and the fact that the economy's tanked and that Brexit has turned out to be far from what people were told, that's part of a much longer story than that, right?
Well, it's just the latest part of it.
Yeah, but that's all about 100 years of economic history and the fact loads of places had stuff taken away and they weren't giving much back. Don't forget what we said in 2016, right? It turned out Britain was so imbalanced it had fallen over. I think we're still sort of lying on the floor moaning, really. I think we're still in shock. Grimsby has received some levelling up money. The council spent a lot of it buying the town's ailing shopping centre and is now waiting on the outcome of other bids. In the meantime, more shops have closed on the high street.
This is a Friday, look, where's the customers? Yeah. The footfall is disappearing and it's going to disappear more.
But there are sort of two sides to the town centre here. Just down there is Abbeygate. It's quite a small sort of shopping arcade where there are a handful of really good independent businesses, right? And then you walk about 30 seconds and you hit the traditional old high street, which is just full of empty retail units. This is where all the level up focus, what there is of it, is on this. It's peculiar.
So you don't vote?
No, I don't vote.
Who should I vote for?
Me.
One liar after another.
People choose to come and trade here as a preference to other places around the world.
Right, but you also want to create a UK where everyone can afford to eat.
Tories out!
Hey!
One of the challenges of making these films, which always sits right at the centre of our thoughts, is how to make films about inequality and crisis while not reducing places to clichés, right?
What's good stuff about Grimsby? What do you like about it?
Fish.
It's a small community, so, like, mainly everyone knows each other. Lived here all my life, so I know quite a lot of people growing up around here.
Family is really important to people growing up around here.
I love living here.
There's real pockets of community and some of the most deprived areas, but yeah, really good sense of community.
I think you do an absolutely fantastic job, and it's just magic. I mean, it was all through walking when you got made redundant, wasn't it? And seeing the mess of the...
I needed to do something.
It throws the deprivation and the inequality into sharper relief because you're saying, well, if only somewhere really had the chance, imagine what could happen. Pam Hodge is the embodiment of that potential and what holds Grimsby together.
These people here have had enough of false promises. When we do something, we make sure that we never close it down. We keep it going, we grow on it.
She started the Rock Foundation to help her son and other people with learning disabilities.
My eldest son had learning disabilities, and then when I was looking around to see what was going to be available for them, I was absolutely horrified. I went ahead and I started it. Started with two, and I started at an old ice, what was called an old ice house, which is just around the corner here. And today we've got around about 90 students.
Wow. The foundation has grown to meet need wherever she sees it. From a group that supports former fishermen.
Oh, fishermen. All right, would you like to join our crew?
Yeah. What happened to the fishing trade in Grimsby? What's the story?
The politics.
To a brilliant supported living project that she thinks could revolutionise adult social care.
Have you had a busy afternoon?
Yes. Got to dig deep though.
I was just saying about funding.
I know, desperate.
Yeah.
So these are the bedrooms?
Yeah.
God, that's brilliant.
We've worked hard.
That's amazing.
Yeah. There's every single time you're thinking, oh my goodness, now what's going to happen? Where are we going to be cut this time? What are we going to be, you know, and what more can we do to try and make ourselves more sustainable?
What about you? Well, I'm very rarely happy. I'm happy now.
Happy now.
Yeah. The last stop on our tour is the location for Pam's next vision, a disused public toilet.
So this is going to be now a food bank plus. People there to look at debt, look at housing. There'll be all sorts of different courses going on. It's going to be a community kitchen up there, probably there to help them do CVs. All sorts of things will be going on. Anything we can to help people. We've got to get this done by Christmas.
By Christmas? You know what's coming, don't you? Yes. Which is that the Chancellor of the Exchequer is going to announce a further spending cut. Yes. Which is that will hit Grimsby like a hammer.
It's going to hit us. It's going to hit everybody. It's going to hit us. Yeah, it's going to be shocking.
It's taken Pam a year to take over the building, during which time the place has been broken into.
They've taken all the wiring out.
They've broken in,
they've come through the roof, they've smashed all the windows. Again, you're waiting all the time. It's like, if we'd only had this a year ago and we should have had it, we would have been ready for this crisis.
But isn't that the sort of general condition of a lot of people here?
It is.
Is that they're waiting?
Waiting.
The government says it wants tax cuts for entrepreneurs and all of that stuff.
Yeah.
But what you don't hear talked about is people like you, who effectively are holding places together, really.
Yeah. We work all hours because we care about the community. We're trying our best here on the ground, and it would be nice to have some support.
God knows it's the easiest thing in the world, isn't it, to say politics is sort of out of touch. But there are also times when it becomes painfully true. And just watching this sort of pantomime at the top, you know, yet another instalment of who's going to have the top job, and all these ambitious people falling over each other to get it. It has nothing to do with what we're in the midst of here. People voted the way they did in the 2016 Brexit referendum and at the 2019 election because they felt that by choosing to leave the EU and voting Conservative, a lot of people won't like me saying this, and I feel a bit uncomfortable saying it, but it's true. In doing those things, somehow they were going to get change, right? And the great sort of tragedy of this crisis we're in the middle of now is, I think, people's sense now that that change isn't coming.
As always.
Because there are some people, amazing people, who just aren't prepared to wait, quite rightly. They understand the urgency of what they're faced with and the need to do something.
Well, I feel we need a politics that's much more based around people like that.
Yeah, yeah. I think that enables and assists people like that and encourages them. Rather than this sense that the best you can hope for is to sit and wait for someone hundreds of miles over there to deign to help you out. I think what this crisis proves is that that idea of things is finished. On the street, the dogs are barking.